evening, everybody, and welcome to tonight, September 30th, Select Board meeting. We have only a couple things on our agenda. We will be going into executive session at the end of the meeting, but our two principal items on the agenda is our 7 o'clock appointment with the Municipal Building Committee, and then we have the Park and Rec Commission is going to talk to us about their warrant articles. Or a member of the Park and Rec Commission is going to talk to us about our articles. So before we get started, the one thing I want to say is we still have a long way to go in the articles and funding all the articles for a special town meeting. So if you don't mind, no motions. Let's hear what everyone has to say and then talk through it all, and then we can go back and try to figure out how to make all this work.
You mean don't go one by one, wait until the end?
Wait until the end, sit through and talk through the articles a little more. We do have, our demands are huge and our pot is very small. We must feed everybody. So with that, I'll let the Municipal Building Committee start with their articles.
Thank you. I appreciate your time tonight. I've distributed for you a copy of our draft articles for the fall town warrant. Andy, would you mind kind of starting the conversation with the first one, and we'll kind of tag team you on this one.
Thanks. Okay, just to it will read a little differently than the version that you saw a couple weeks ago. We dropped one article, postponed another one for spring town meeting. That is the catch-all reallocation of funds for projects out there. We got a few more projects that are still in the works, and if there happen to be pigeonholed funds, then we want to capture them at that point. There's not a lot of money. So doing that, we reorganized this a little bit to make them, some of them a little bit more conditional. The first article, which is number 16, the reallocation of Russell School stabilization money, that is the $100,000 that's in a fund now that requires, you know, two-thirds town meeting approval to access. We would like it to be transferred to a fund similar to the Senior Center and Town Hall Roof Repair Fund, which is a little bit more liquid, allowing us to use it in a more timely manner than having, you know, semi-annual town meeting access to it, especially when we'd like to, you know, try to mothball and do repairs in that building.
There's some safety improvements that would have to be accomplished fairly soon for the winter season. There's currently smoke detectors in the facility. Once the heat is down, those will need to be transferred over to heat detectors. Smoke detectors won't work in freezing temperatures. Other things just to simply protect our building for the long term, for the short term, until we determine a better use for it. So some of these things are moving pretty quickly, and we're just a little concerned that the money isn't really available without a secondary vote by the town to allocate individual funds to do those projects.
Okay, just a question. This money is available to use right now at Russell School.
Only with the two-thirds majority vote of town meeting.
Okay.
And only Russell School.
And only Russell School. And the mothballing will be how much?
Scary?
Yeah.
Just a ballpark. Is it 10,000? Is it 30?
I would think it's between that. Let's say about 20,000.
Thank you.
It all depends on what we find. The big issue is the next article that you see there, which we might be able to pass over.
Okay.
Article 17 is about the seismic. That's the critical issue that we have with our buildings, and what we'd like to utilize those funds for is the use Lindgren and Charples, who's our consultant, to do the report and pay through that fund, so we can use the money that we already have set aside from town meeting voter $50,000 in other areas that we're going to need. So that's the other critical area that we'd like to use that funding for. And there was an estimate already on that.
Yep, and so we'll just back up though. Mm-hmm. To be clear, we're not asking to reallocate the funds to another building.
No.
We think it's important to preserve that account for Russell School. It's just that we can't touch it at all to even mothball the building or prepare it for winter without some action. So that's the article in question.
So you've got seismic, you've got the consultant, we've got mothballing and safety issues, all of which there are monies that are now tied up that originally were, you know, that rent account that we'd like to gain access to rather than, and keep, again, as David said, keep it all within Russell School.
Okay, before we leave that article, any other comments, questions?
I just have a question on the, so it says to transfer from the stabilization account, transfer to another account, just a special account that's under the control of the select board and...
So if you transfer from one account to the other, you're back in the same boat. You need a two-thirds majority vote to transfer in and out of the stabilization account. It sounds like the article that needs to be written, if this article is to be supported, is to transfer the entire balance of the $100,000 from the Russell School stabilization account for the purpose of repairing and renovating Russell School. And then that creates it as an account that's been approved by the two-thirds majority vote, and then it's subject to just appropriation from the department head who has authorization to do that.
But that's what I'm asking, so that would be the select board.
Yep.
That would have, so the municipal building committee would recommend, we'd approve, and then that's
correct.
How you'd get the money.
Just like we've been doing with all the others.
Yeah.
Yep.
Can we condense this if we're going to fund the seismic, the mothballing, and everything else so that we don't have a problem with this? I mean, if it takes us the $80,000 for the seismic, the mothballing, and everything else that you guys are going to recommend tonight to us for that building, can we transfer that into an account which is accessible after town meeting vote of $100,000 to be used there so we don't have to go back six times and we
right.
do this just one time?
So long as you keep the language general of repair and renovation.
Which is really what you guys are trying to
yes.
do, right?
Right.
Okay.
Then you can enter into your three phases of your
as you know, we were very specific in the last fall's articles, which forced our hand to maintain individual accounts for all the projects that we had recommended. One goes over, one goes under, we need to come back to you, which is part of what we're doing today. But so I think you get it.
And we need your advice and David's advice and town council on how the wording, so we can make sure that these things go forward in the correct manner. That's all we're asking.
So I'm going to break my rule automatically. I think we're all in agreement. I don't know motion, but I think we're all in agreement. That's kind of what we want to do, right?
Okay. I absolutely am.
We need to open it up for us and them, us being the final decision, of course. But if we don't open this stuff up and take any action on it, we're back to doing nothing to our buildings again.
Okay.
And I think that's what you're trying to say.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So, go ahead.
Is there anything else that we need to fold into this Article 16 other than the seismic and of the other articles that are going to be talked about now initially?
Tree
is there anything that you would like folded into your current Article 16?
17 was the only other article that we would
okay.
fold into 16.
These three right here.
David,
so the
wording
should be
general
enough that we
can
yeah. use it. That's all.
Right.
Okay.
So what we should probably say is we do know some things we do want to do. So we can tell the people at the town meeting we do want to spend $47,500 for the seismic study.
I want to clarify that.
Or do you want to round it up?
No, I want to not recommend the full study as yet. You have in front of you the Lindgren and Sharples proposal for the Russell School study. This is purposely written in a three-phase approach.
Mm-hmm.
The first being to better understand the seismic capacity, if you will, of the Russell School as it exists today. Also the floor capacities for different use groups, things like that. Before we do that and we determine what we can and cannot do with it, that's our first approach. The second is to look at a planning study where we repurpose it and we look at all of the departments and see if we can get them to sort of test fit in there. And then beyond that is more of a design, like a schematic design of those of those functions. So we think it's premature to recommend phase two and phase three move ahead at this point before we get a full analysis of the seismic.
Okay.
So that is the first phase, which is only $7,750.
So you are recommending the full seismic study. You have to do that in order to get the answer.
The full seismic is only $7,700.
Right.
And
but that would need absolutely
need
to
that
do
that
before
we do need
do
that, but it's not $47,000.
Right.
It's 7,000. A small portion of the
revenue.
But David,
full
do we not want to ask for the full amount and have it available, and we can
and then we don't have to go back.
It.
Well, right. All I want to do is kind of like have a list for the public so they know that.
Right.
Now you're gonna we're gonna approve setting up another account for this building, and out of that account, there's going to be up to $47,500 possibly spent on engineering and design,
yes.
And then there's going
yes.
to be up to another $20,000 to $30,000 spent on mothballing and securing the building
right.
before winter starts, and then there'll be another little group of money left over that'll be for incidentals that come up along the way.
Yes.
Right.
I'd like to like
okay.
I just want to tell the public.
Yeah,
but
also
that's
saying
that's
to them
plan.
That the money is there for us. To use, but we need to put it into a different account.
Yes.
But and that way they would understand it.
Yes. Thank you.
But respectfully in telling everybody if the seismic information comes back negatively, then
we're
the money shouldn't and need
and,
not
and as
be spent.
Not aware of architect, I knew nothing about what seismic meant at all. So that also is a good explanation for somebody to
earthquakes.
What?
Earthquakes.
Yeah.
We need to say right. earthquakes.
You never know what's going to happen.
Or big trucks.
The code refers to it as seismic.
Big trailer truck going
it,
through.
It right. ultimately is. You know, I do train stations, and the vibration of the trains,
sure.
we consider a seismic capacity as well. But the one thing I'd ask you to consider, we have a proposal today for that first phase of the study. I'd like to advance it sooner rather than later. Is it possible to look at using the project consultant account now and replenishing it, or some other factor which we could do phase one without waiting for the fall warrant?
Yes, you haven't spent. Well, you have spent some of that money.
Very little. Yeah, it was for the asbestos abatement.
No, we took
design.
That out of the other fund, so
okay.
we don't
so there's not.
It was
so,
only a little bit taken out.
Take
we,
that out of the 50 decided.
You can't expend anything that doesn't. That has been appropriated, so.
Yeah, so we appropriated $50,000 for the on-call services.
Right.
Yeah.
So we can spend that.
We just want to make sure that if we take it out of that account, we can put it back in from this Russell's. You know, we complicate. We just want to like to complicate it.
Yeah,
you're just
yeah.
moving money.
What we're
yeah, yeah.
What's money?
How much is left in the on-call services account? Do you know off the top?
49, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think we've only spent a minimal amount, something like $49,000.
We spent 49?
We did spend.
I mean, not spent.
Right.
There should
left.
Be 49 yeah. left.
So I agree that we should go ahead and move forward with, mm-hmm. and that can come out of the money, the $49,000 that's left. My original approach.
No, he can't make
motion.
We're not making motions.
That's the rules.
I broke my rule. I told you I would do this. But no, I agree with that. But you've already got the money appropriated to you. You can come back with the agreement, then we can sign the agreement.
Again, we just want to make sure
the gentleman's
that
agreement
forward,
is between us that the 77
yeah.
goes
yeah,
back.
We want you to
yeah.
agree
to seismic
sign.
Now.
Yeah.
Well,
okay,
we
so.
We're
okay with
well,
it.
Well, I mean, the agreement's right here. You just give it to us.
Yeah, and we've already executed the first task order with Mr. Nixon, so we'll just do this as task two, and it would be mm-hmm. phase one of this full study, 77.5.
Right, so we should amend this when we're ready to sign this, just cross out the cost of phase two and phase three and make sure that we're explicit that we're only funding 7,700.
Has the engineer been made aware of any of this?
Okay. Oh, yes.
Thank you.
Yes. It was our conversation between him and I that we thought this made sense to go about the approach.
So then actually, if we get it all done really quick and we find out that we can't save the building, which would be a shame, then we have a whole lot of money for the next phase.
That's right.
Right. But the goal is to actually try to save this building, I think.
Yes.
Clearly.
Yeah. Clearly it is.
Okay.
So phase two and three, you will wait until spring?
No, phase two and three will be part of the articles in the fall. This will advance immediately.
Mm-hmm.
The fall article will include the engineering money for those second and third phases.
Okay.
I'm assuming Article 17 now can be stricken from
Well, if we, how about if we don't get the two-thirds vote?
I think you'll get the two, you'll get the two-thirds.
You get passed over at a town meeting.
Yeah, but leave it in there as an insurance policy.
Well, but we were talking about folding it into 16.
No, only if it passed.
Right, if 16 passes, then we just pass over 17. If for some reason 16 doesn't pass.
Then you won't fold it into 16.
If we did a very bad job getting, not getting 16 passed, we're not going to get 17 passed.
Yeah, that's right.
It's Hadley Town Meeting, we should, I mean, you never know, you never know.
The points are is that this is a building that needs work. The $100,000 is from rental income, there's no impact upon taxes. This is the purpose to which this account was dedicated in the first place by town meeting vote.
If we don't go with 15, then I don't think 17 will pass.
I agree. I'm just saying, stranger things have happened, and I don't want these guys to be in a situation where we can't roll forward with the project because we didn't have a stopgap measure. That's all.
I'm saying this. Yeah, but you're missing what I'm saying. There is no stopgap. If they don't approve it the first time, they're not going to approve it the second time.
We're coming back to it anyway. Move on.
And honestly, if we take the seismic money out of the consultant money that's already banked, 17 becomes moot because we're going to circumvent that.
Right. Okay. So 16, 17, 18.
Okay. So 18 is the building maintenance budgets. You want to kind of give the backstory on this one?
Okay, well, we've been putting together a second list of projects, and really the genesis of this article was that, as we continue to create critical needs lists and the situation where we got ourselves into trouble by enumerating costs in the article, we wound up pigeonholing funds, and it started to make sense that if we're doing building maintenance on as a larger scope, it's now becoming more of a function. I mean, you guys, the town approved a building and maintenance coordinator, whatever the specific title was, a couple of years ago. This task really has no dedicated line item in general. Right now, it's at my understanding is under at least three different departments for specific buildings. And that doesn't allow a lot of economies of scale. It doesn't allow a lot of moving from one department to the other if necessary. And besides, we'd like to, it hasn't allowed for, it's been barely, if Gary was here, he would back me up, but it's barely covered the minimal amount of maintenance. It doesn't really offer any expenditure for preventative maintenance. This is we're in the point where we've been kicking the can down the road, and this is the financial structure that behind that. The committee has talked about ways of looking forward the next 20, 30, 50 years and maybe establishing a budget like other municipalities have to deal with their buildings and invest in their capital and make repairs without having to go to town meeting every time we need to make a repair. We don't need to wait months to get it approved. And, you go through an approval process with oversight from the select board, but the current methodology is rather cumbersome, and it doesn't allow for general oversight of what are we spending on, siding for all the buildings or roofs or the like. And we have to kind of pull from several directions. So creating a budget, establishing a work order system, those are things that the committee thought would be a good proposal. There's been some back and forth as to rolling in the current 490 account out there, which has a number of different, which is under the DPW now, and there was some concern as to whether or not we should try to tackle this all in one shot by establishing a new account and a new work order system at the same time pulling the existing system and doing away with that. Some thought might be, let's build a new one, leaving the old one in place for a little bit, and then roll it all in a year or so once we kind of get things underway, so we don't totally disrupt the flow of repairs and maintenance. So that's where we came about looking at a budget. The $200,000 number, admittingly, was a general number, but it certainly has been easily justified as the time has gone on and we put together a new project list.
So by doing it this way, it's increasing the amount in 490. 490 is under the purview of the DPW director.
Well,
in terms of expending the funds.
Our original recommendation did not include the rolling up of the 490. That was something that came about through the back and forth process. And again, we've since discussed that and share some concerns that it may not be another $66,000 allocated there to start. Maybe the number gets mitigated a bit, but we certainly have $200,000 in the next round of maintenance, and it would be good to have the budget from which to deploy this money rather than take it at a project-by-project level.
Do you guys have like a list that we can provide? If we move forward with this article, is there a list of what we're shooting for to spend this money on?
Well, I mean, as we discussed when we toured the buildings recently, there's some catch-up we have to do. I mean, there will be, at some point, there will be a longer-term plan for expenditures. You know, we'll be painting the town hall every 5 years, or we'll be maintaining, you know, ceiling tiles or something. I mean, it's going to take us a while before we get to the point where we have a full recommendation that goes out that far. But the catch-up work includes the things that we talked about during our tour, and you know, right now looking at them, they probably equate to about $100,000 worth of repairs. We have a number of items that were on the DRA report that we'd like to incorporate as well. We don't have the full list for you tonight. I know Andy's been working on what we call our critical building needs project list, which is how we provided it to you last year. And that was really useful, but we're a little bit behind the eight ball here in terms of getting some estimates for some of this work and making sure we have enough contingency funds in there so that we don't have any overages like we did on one or two of the projects from last fall.
So these here on the original context of the MBC under this purview here, not everything has been done there. So is that what you want incorporated into the $200,000 that you're going to use the money for?
That's right. This includes the
So paint. Is this a partial list?
Yes.
This is a partial list. This is getting started. I mean, we're being a little cautious because last time, as you all know, we put it all out there. This is how much every project's going to cost, and then we had some trouble with that. So we want to give you a full and inclusive list, but we want to be careful not to put all the budgets in individual places so that you can't meet.
You get it. We get that part. But we have to. But you get my part too.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we gotta be able to tell the people this is what you're gonna spend the list to spend it on.
And absolutely.
If there's money left over, we go on to something else. If there's not money left over, we have to ask for more. So.
Right.
And it's also just during the fiscal year, because this is increasing a specific budget line item for this fiscal year. So we don't want to go to town meeting and asking people to say, oh, well, we're planning on doing, you know, these 12 things when it's not humanly possible to get them all done.
Mm-hmm.
And just thinking about when we did do the tour, just this building here, one of the things we talked about being very critical were some of the safety concerns about the parking lot and that
drainage.
Mm-hmm. The repointing had to happen in the foundation first, and then, you know, so I would, to Guilford's point, I think the story to tell people this is what we could do and when, and only ask for enough money to cover that.
I think we can flesh that list together and
harden
that number a bit as we're playing catch up, trying to get some numbers back in. It's a busy time to track down contractors this time of year.
By next Wednesday,
We can work towards that.
We get the
most of that. I know you only have a few more shots at the apple, bites at the apple here, which I completely get it. I want to be fair. You know, we might be able to get most of it in place by then. For you to look at.
Certainly by priority anyways. Mm-hmm. So that, you know.
Right.
And then the number.
Did you see the original list from last year, Jerry?
I did.
This is the updated original list for you guys to have. That gives you the completeness of all, and quite honestly, quite a bit done. And you know, there's just a few more things left to be done. Certainly the weather's going to impede us on a couple. And I think with regard to our list, I think that's one of the things that we can talk about is weather and what we can do prior to springtime. and put that together and have something pretty solid. So
if we do add it to this line item, yeah, like Ms. Keegan said, I mean, we only have until the end of June to finish, Molly.
It's fiscal.
Being nice. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we'll be practical about that. I mean, we've already had discussions. Can we do paint? Can we do certain things over the winter time frame? So we're meeting on Tuesday next week, and that'll be a point that we discuss. And our goal would be to get you a very similar matrix for the upcoming projects. That was more or less what we started with last year, and I thought it was pretty well organized in terms of what we were getting from the money. So,
if memory serves me correctly, so we just talked about the what it would be for this building, and then for the senior center, it was that entryway off to the side, right? That would be a priority, and then there's some damage being caused from the moisture at the safety complex.
Right.
I mean, I'm just thinking about those from the walkthrough as opposed to what's on here right now, which is the, you know, columns.
I have my own list, and I think the other thing that we hadn't talked about, Molly, was countertops for the work areas on the first floor. There were a couple of laminate countertops that we were interested in replacing. Then more importantly was the full-depth reconstruction of the parking lot and drainage improvements. And I think we all thought that was budgeted under a DPW budget or somewhere else.
He was doing a number, wasn't he?
Yeah.
He was just working on a number.
Okay, he's working up a number, so it's not budgeted. So it should be
parking
included.
Lot here?
Yeah.
I mean, you can see some of the issues we have with slopes of asphalt and tripping hazards.
So we've got.
How far are we? How much of this driveway are we sharing with the church?
That's a good question. We do not have that as of yet, but it is a concern that it is not our driveway, not our parking lot.
Right.
And right now, that's what the survey is. The surveyor has not given us the final. That's what he has stated directly to me.
And the town museum belongs to us or not?
No. Does not.
Does not.
What he is having a very difficult time to finish up this survey because it's so old. But the discussions I've had with him directly is the land that the town owns is only the land that the building sits on and nothing else. So that creates an issue because this land actually came from the church. So then there's going to be a discussion with regard to that. I think we've used it in the past to the point that
we must have squatters' rights by now.
I would think that we do.
Easement. It's called easement.
This is one of these projects which we may not accomplish by the end of the budget year.
We may not want to put that in this number, though. Mm.
Right.
We might want to put it
at the bottom.
Yeah, but at least get the preparatory work done.
Just trying to think of places to go that could conceivably fund this request. Have you considered CPA funds for these projects? Because a lot of these projects are mentioned. You mentioned the DAR report. There's also the Historic Building Preservation Report. All of those projects are CPA eligible.
They were saying that these are maintenance items.
Yeah,
they changed the statutory definition of what maintenance is so that the rules are now a lot less
they
strict.
Is the state,
state
not our
the state
not our committee.
Was that done recently?
This was done about 2 or 3 years ago.
Okay, so when we went to the last time we approached for repairs and maintenance for the CPA money, it was deemed that it had to be at the had to be a project level, not just merely a repair.
And it had to be life lengthening, right?
All right. So even the doors were not considered.
Or the roofs.
But you know, bringing the doors back to historic appearance with modern materials, that was not considered. CPA
eligible. Yeah,
I'm raising this mainly because the CPA is there for a reason. We have a lot of money locked up in CPA right now, and it would be interesting to see what we could do with some of that money towards renovating these buildings.
We've been working with the CPA for the past couple of weeks. We had a meeting Monday. We have another meeting coming up this Monday on some of the funds. We had Dr. Boston to get some information from Boston whether how much money we can get for properties and buildings, and it's getting very stringent now. And the money for the buildings that we talked about is, sorry, that's maintenance, and it doesn't comply for CTA funds. So that's...
The request last year was this, went the same route. We did ask, and they told us no. We've not asked on this round, and whether the local CPA has changed their mind in any way, we can't say for sure. And I can see your position. If that is, in fact, a state position, then we have some rights to that money for the repairs.
Just trying to think of pots of money that could be helpful to...
So we'll ask again.
We've been talking all about the property in North Hadley, and that's touching on quite a bit. But as soon as we finish with that, when we see what else we've got, then we'll probably see if we can finagle something with them and go over that.
We had also talked about getting CPA here at a select board meeting so that we could have this conversation, mm-hmm. like kind of once and for all, and not keep... It seems like we just keep kicking it back and forth all the time. Mm-hmm. I mean, I agree with you. To the extent there are funds available, we should try to use them.
Can you give us that law?
Sure.
Actually, it's pretty big.
Well, yeah. I mean, just pinpoint where it says what it can be used for.
There's an opinion from Koppelman and Page about the definition and what it means. I can provide that. It's only a couple pages.
But even if just Edwin could come, that'd be helpful.
Yeah.
Well, but for fall town meeting, we're a little
late.
Yeah.
There was, I believe, an email exchange that went back and forth, which is where they addressed this concept of the repair versus the project level for CPA access.
Mm-hmm. It really is a fine line, too.
Yeah.
At the point where if we wrote a grant and went ahead with a town hall rebuilding over at Russell School or something like that, then that funds, those portions of those funds couldn't be probably tapped at that time, along with some grant money possibly and the CPA funds. But we're nowhere near that yet, because the past boards over the last 10 years have done no maintenance, period. And we've been through this for the last year.
But we're looking forward now, aren't we?
Yep.
Very excited.
We're doing the best we can now, for sure.
There was no money before the taxes came in for, I want to reiterate that, for meal taxes and hotel taxes. That's where, finally, we were able to get some extra money and start to do these projects. Before that, there was none.
Which is a great lead into my point.
Excellent.
And that's that if somebody could be able to speak to the projects that you did actually accomplish this year, I think people would see how important it is. I don't think it should be a very long, time-consuming thing, but I think if people see that we're all working in the same direction, trying to improve all these buildings, I think people will be a lot more supportive regarding that.
The matter of $200,000 in tax rate is pennies on a dollar right now, and I would be in favor of appropriating that money just for this reason, because it's been laxed for so long. Our town buildings were falling apart, falling down, because of the past boards.
Oh, Jesus.
And that's why CPD says they won't allow any money for maintenance, strictly for...
Okay, so let's move on. Yeah. Let's move away from this.
I'm having fun.
I know. I like
to. We have more to do.
Not room for us without your soapbox up here.
Number 19.
So the next two articles, 19 and 20, are an attempt to ensure that we are able to request the monies we need for these repairs, despite the approval or not approval of Article 18. Similar to the way Andy arranged the first couple articles.
Mm-hmm. When you talked, you weren't here. The other night at last week at your meeting, you wanted to incorporate these articles. And is that what you're meaning, that if one goes, then the other ones are out? Instead of incorporating them, you're just going to omit them?
That's correct. If 18 were to pass, then you would skip 19 and 20.
Okay, because mm-hmm. I thought you were, I got the gist that you were combining them.
We did talk about that.
So do you have the numbers for 19 and 20?
No. We get those for you.
Estimates.
Then my other question, is everything on 19 and 20, can it be done by the end of June?
think that's something that we have to discuss in our meeting on Tuesday next week to be realistic about what can be achieved prior to the close of the year.
On 19, though, I mean, it looked like...
Well, 20 certainly.
The roof was going to get done in the spring, because we can't do it now with the PSC. And the town columns...
If you ask me, yeah, I think they can be. If we have the money appropriated, everything in 19 and 20 are things that have been around for some time, and we certainly can do it.
Yeah.
So then the question is...
We'll get prices.
Yeah, okay.
And just one other thing that I suspect might come up at town meeting is, to the extent that we, looks like it's a go and the money's available for that, people are going to want to know, how are these projects being managed? So where's the oversight coming from? Is it Gary Berg? Is it the Municipal Building Committee?
Depends on the project.
Right, so I mean, I just think if you're going to go through them one by one, maybe you...
Set a column up for the oversight.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And now, having a project consultant, we can engage someone else if necessary to help us.
Okay.
You're doing a great job. You don't need anybody else's help.
There's only so many hours in the day.
Let's go to the big ones.
Okay.
Big ones.
So as we're at Article 21, property purchase, I'm going to sort of tee this up for you all to discuss, but as you recall, last fall we had the non-binding agreement or approval of an article to look for property in the North Hadley area for a fire substation. Chief Spanknebel was there and kind of laid out his thoughts on response times and other things, and we have found an agreeable property, one that would suit our needs. We've in fact used some CAD files and surveys to do a site plan of the property, which would allocate a significant amount of the parcel, let's say 90% of that parcel, towards parks and recreational areas. The parcel is bigger than we need for the fire substation. We're only going to have a certain amount of time to act on it, probably. It's for sale, public sale. But I think we haven't heard from the select board yet as to your opinion about whether there's a true need for a fire substation. I think the chief has been very clear about what he feels or what's necessary, but we need approval to advance the article if that's the way you'd like to go with it.
I definitely feel, because of response times, that there needs to be a substation in North Hadley, not only for fire, but for police. If something happens here in the center of town, we have no other place for even the police with a dispatch area. I think it's of the utmost importance to have another fire station. A substation, not a full one.
What I'd like to also interject with that statement is that it can be used as a backup in case of an emergency if anything happens with it. And I think that we keep on forgetting about that with regard to our thought process of going forward with something.
I don't think people actually knew, or majority of people in town, that there is actually a dispatch area upstairs in that fire station. You know, hard to get to.
It's archaic.
Antiquated.
Yes. So, but I mean, it was there, it still needs to be there, and I think we should, you know, continue that. With all the houses and everything that are still being built up in North Hadley, I think it's important.
Capital planning, oh, I'm sorry. The capital planning had some questions regarding this piece of property, and I don't actually know how much we can talk about here, but the piece of property came, there's been two significantly different sale figures on that piece of property. One is what it's listed for now, and what is a different number that I've heard. Are we able to talk to that?
Well, we got an RFI. We got one response from our RFI, and that one response was this property. And they did not give us a figure for the sale.
Which one are you talking about?
Yours.
Well, the one on River Drive.
Yes.
We have a definitive price on that one. We talked to I talked to the CPA, and they're going to give us money for the part of the property, which is going to be park and rec, and then whatever's left over will be to buy the piece for the fire station. But it'll be one piece of property, and, all 9.6 acres is what it is.
So the number I've heard mentioned by people in this room.
Okay, if you don't want to get in trouble, what is the assessed value of that property?
Well,
we know what that is, but that
what is it?
That's old. Those are old figures.
We're getting our new one, Doug.
We're getting brand new figures as of today. I talked to the an appraiser.
Certified appraiser.
We are kind of putting the, you know, we talk about putting the car up in front of the horse. You can't really, I mean, we have a person who's willing to sell to us, but then we still have to get money appropriated and still have to go through a request for proposal to buy it.
Because CPA requires it.
Well, the state requires it, yes. But okay. So my take on this piece of property is publicly listed on, if you go online, you go to MLS, yeah. It's publicly listed at just under $500,000.
For seven building lots, and there's other stuff which we can discuss that goes along with that, between the individual that has the property and the two contractors that are discussing it.
No, it's listed, it's publicly listed.
For sale.
Right.
For sale, mm-hmm. At less than $500,000.
Correct.
With no strings attached, it says there's a possibility of so many building lots, and it's 9.5 acres.
That's seven building lots, and according to what this deal is, that these contractors are working out with the owners. Now, and I'm not at liberty to say what the private workup is of the sale for that price, but we have the one price that we agreed on, we talked about last year, for the whole piece of property.
We haven't, the town hasn't agreed on a price.
No, we talked about a price, and
yes.
We're looking to CPA to get so much money, and then the town will have to, and then we're going to bring it up at the town meeting. We'll let you people know once next week what the prices are, how much we can get from CPR, and how much it's going to cost the town. Then bring it to the town and see if they want to vote on it and approve it. But we've got to have figures. Like you said, you want figures. Well, we're getting the
we need estimates. We need an estimate to put in the town meeting.
This is going to be definite.
No. It's not definite until you put the RFP out.
I
understand. It's not definite until we do the proposal and get the responses back. I know what you're saying.
Not definite.
We have good estimates.
Number. You have a good solid estimate to put into this Article 21 to propose to the people. We're going to have a definitive price to put in this article.
Yeah.
I don't care if it's an RFP, RFI, RPG.
Can we bring this conversation back to
it? I was just going to say that one option you have in order to make this conversation move forward is you can go into executive session over the negotiation of real estate. So
yes.
Just want to throw that out there.
I know that this is about the purchase of property, but I think that the reason particularly, we had asked Mike to come and other Mike too tonight. Was there are an awful lot of questions that float around relative to the actual need. So before we're talking about purchasing anything, I think we really need to put the needs analysis to bed once and for all, if you will. I would say I certainly get a lot of questions from people. There's people who are absolutely completely in lockstep that of course we have to have a North Hadley fire station. What's taking you so long? When are we going to move on it? And then there are other people that continue to question whether or not we actually do need a North Hadley fire station. Do the response times justify it? Is it just for equipment? Is it because we've bought so much equipment that we're looking for another? I mean, these are just things that people float out there, so I'm repeating what I hear. So what I was hoping tonight is that we could hear from Mike, you know, again, if you could kind of recap that needs analysis so we can just put it out there publicly.
Can I just interject one
sure.
thing? I mean, don't focus too much on the fire station right now because it's a small portion of that parcel. This is an opportunity for the town to get more land for ourselves for playing fields and things, and it's only about a tenth of that space. So we don't necessarily have to put a building up tomorrow or in 10 years from now. It's, that's not the whole focus right now. It's just available. So
and I agree, but just devil's advocate on that.
Yeah.
If you just leave it at that, then people are going to say, well, wait a minute. I thought the schools just picked up 7 acres of land. What's going on with that? We own all this land, and there's no money to develop that. Are we shooting ourselves in the foot and just doing the same thing here? And again, I know the ownership and control issues around school playing fields and all of that stuff. So I think that's a very valid point. But again, if we're going to line up at town meeting asking people to spend that kind of money, it's not the fire station. I think people need to know that too. So
if we put this off and we don't get it on the ballot for people to vote on, then by December 31st, and we can't give that fellow an answer after the town meeting if he's selling the property. We have until December 31st to make a decision on whether we're going to buy that property or not.
Right, so the more information we put in front of town meeting, the greater chance of sound decision being made.
This is why we pushed this, is because we were told that we were told to get rid of the North Hadley Hall. And the best thing, way to do that is to move Park and Rec and to find a place to put the fire station. This is where we, and this was the avenue we took, was to put a fire station and get a piece of property that's big enough.
Chief, would you like to talk a little bit about where we are, where we aren't in the needs assessment right now?
Well, I mean, I've done multiple needs assessment. You have the MRI report that clearly suggests that they felt that you do need it. I've done road studies on it. I've done call evaluations, response times, FPA standard.
So what is it? You went over your SWOT last time. Was it last time or the time? You went over your SWOT with us, your strengths, weaknesses, opportunities and threats.
Yep.
So as you look through that, what do you see is, if you had the money now, what would you want to move forward with? Is it to build a new station and staff a new station, or build a new station in North Hadley, or is it to do other things, to look into other possibilities? I mean, that's really where we're at here. The pot, as I said earlier, the pot's only so big. If we do this article, my concern is if we do this article, we put money aside and we buy a piece of property. Yes, we could use it for another purpose, but we may not be ready to do what we want to do with the fire station. So the question, I guess, from us or from me is, you know, are we 100% sure this is the number one thing we wish to do with the fire department?
No, it's not the number one thing to do. The number one priority would be to get a full-time fire department staff in the town of Hadley. That would be my number one priority, and have it supported by an ambulance. That would be the number one priority. However, you're asking, again, the cart before the horse. And so you're asking me to give you information, which I'm giving, doing public outreach with it, asking folks' opinions, giving you studies and evaluations. As a fire chief, I can tell you that having two people in town that are full-time with a 26-person call force, there is no option of taking away that North Hadley station. That's my opinion. That's my professional opinion as a fire chief. Having a lot of experience going to calls up there, I know we've discussed, you know, seeing trucks respond, getting at this, you know, maybe in a specific time frame that may have happened. But I can tell you there's numerous, probably too numerous to count how many times there's one truck showing up there with one person on it getting it started. So, you know, again, there's a lot of stuff that we're going through. So it kind of has a lot of little cogs in this wheel that have to be reviewed and looked at. And do I think building a new fire station is the priority? No, I don't. We have a fire station with fire trucks in it right now. We have a building up north that has our trucks in it. But, I mean, we've had in capital for how many years now just to do some basic repairs to keep that building operational. Could we stay in North Hadley Hall? Absolutely, we could stay in North Hadley Hall with those upgrades. Am I saying it's the best idea for growth for the 100 years down the road that we're looking at? No. So my problem is I keep getting asked to make statements, and I'm just kind of, I don't even know what to say anymore because I've given all the information I can possibly give. So
can,
again,
can I try
I got a question for both of the chiefs. Both of you chiefs have been here for quite a few years. Both of you chiefs have been through a few emergency preparedness things. Right now, with our two buildings, with all of our buildings, if a hurricane or a tornado or a major flood came through here and took the dike out over on West Street, do we have the facilities and do we have the...
Happy trips.
What?
We were just contemplating what would happen if the dike...
Do we have the facilities to take care of our citizens? Would that, would a new building over the next 50 years or 75 years help us up there?
You're talking about a fire station as acting as a shelter or as acting as an operations center?
As an operations center.
As an operations center? I've stated that 100 times.
Through the police and the fire. I know I spoke to both of you about this. And both of you, yeah, exactly.
Yes, the whole plan was...
You don't feel we need that right now. Is that what you're trying to say?
Of course I feel that we need it, but you're asking, it's like a double-edged sword. I mean...
Well, I know.
You're asking, you've already...
Just like Molly said there's people wondering where the new fire station is right now, but there's other people that are just dead against those fires. Sell the fire trucks along with the North Hadley Fire Station, it's over. And that's where, what some of the opinions are.
So maybe there needs to be more outreach to the town so that they understand exactly where we're at, because maybe some people don't understand that.
So that's what where I was going with this is, in I know how frustrated you are because
our initial when we first met.
Yeah, but I'm talking to Mike.
There's a lot.
I know
of
you're frustrated too, but Mike's frustrated because he has provided information time and time again, and yet the questions keep coming up. So what that says to me is that we haven't framed the story the right way, because people keep coming in and saying, "But what about this? What about that?" So part of my thought, Mike, is that, you know, again, there are a lot of people in town who have opinions about things unencumbered with any facts whatsoever. But if we could frame the need, if it is your opinion that we need a station in North Hadley, be able to explain exactly what that does, to Guilford's point, we also have to put it in the context of, if ultimately the town needs a full-time fire department, and you're going to be advocating for that, but we know that we can't do that within the next 12 months, somebody's going to say, then why are we throwing money away by trying to put a building up in North Hadley if the end game is that we're actually looking... And I think you know why you are advocating for this, but you're also going on record saying this isn't the end of it this does not solve our fire department needs.
Yeah,
correct?
Basically what I'm trying to say is, regardless of whether you asked me what the priority was. So the priority is staffing. Do I think that, you know, number two is keeping that North Hadley station? Absolutely. It's like I said, we gotta look at it two ways here. There's the staffing issue, but there's also having redundancy, like John was saying.
Mm-hmm.
So the North Hadley Station, as part of the capital project, before we decided to even sell it, there was capital requests in there to update it.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, you used to sit upstairs for the meetings on the second floor. There was the ability to actually set up an operation center. That's why we have a military surplus generator in that space that can be rolled out of the building to, you know, provide power in the event that our station at center was, you know, was... we weren't able to stay in it. So let's say even a sprinkler had one up.
Yeah. That was all through the civil defense plan way back.
Correct. So the civil defense plan has the North Hadley Station as the alternate operation center. We have multiple shelters that we have redundancy for. So again, what do I say we absolutely need the North Hadley Fire Station regardless of whether we have full-time staffing or not? Yes. But absolutely do we need it if we don't have full-time staffing in place.
Okay. Ensign, could you just talk a little bit then, again, for people that want to understand it, you're talking about, so we have the call force, obviously now, two full-time and then a call force. So can you just quickly explain the role that the North Hadley Fire Station plays in our current structure.
The North Hadley Station currently houses a frontline engine and also an older, it's called our M5, it's a mini pumper. Very usable piece of apparatus. It was actually crucial at our 206 Russell Street fire. It was in probably 4 feet of water for 24 hours. So even though it looks archaic, it still has a place in our department because it can put a lot of water on a fire. Mm-hmm. So basically, the way it was originally designed by past chiefs was that the town was split in half. So Huntington Road basically was the dividing line, you know, specific distance before and after that. So the folks to the north of Huntington Road would respond to the North Hadley Station, and the folks to the south of that would respond to Center Station. So it cuts the town in half, basically. They did that by evaluating response times, and that's what we confirmed by going out and just doing it ourselves. Driving at a reasonable rate in a fire truck to see how long it takes to get from Center Station or North Station to those parts of the community. Also adding in there, having a call force member get out of their bed at the furthest distance from the town, just, you know, for based upon, we do have some folks that actually live over the line in Sunderland, how long it takes them to get to North Hadley Station and then respond back to an incident on Shattuck Road or in the Cummins Road area. So that's what all that was done. So those folks right now, I say we probably have maybe 6 active firefighters that live up in the North Hadley part of town. So during the days, it's a ghost town. We have a very, very limited staff. So it's Nick, our full-time fire prevention, myself, and we have 1 or 2 on the DPW at this point that can still respond to calls and actually do interior firefighting. So it's a real hit or miss on who's in town during the day because folks have jobs out of town now. Mm-hmm. So basically, it is critical. I can tell you we have one gentleman that works overnight at Stop and Shop, so during the day, he is in town. He is our number one person that's on that truck during the day in the event that there's a fire. We have a farmer up in North Hadley that we all know that also will drop everything if a particular calls in where he knows that there needs to be somebody who can get that truck to the scene. So
people who are physically proximate to the North Hadley Station.
Correct.
Go there first,
yes.
Get the equipment, and bring it.
Yes.
Because I have heard that that's not the case, and that everybody goes to Central Station, for lack of a better way to call it, and then gets deployed out. And I just want to make it clear that that is not happening.
That is not happening.
Okay.
That is not correct.
Right.
There are, like I said, there are a couple of folks that live on that dividing line, on the
Huntington.
Actually on Huntington Road. Mm-hmm. So we have more apparatus at Center Station. So ultimately, yes, if we could get extra folks at Center Station to bring that equipment up, that's obviously a priority. So it's kind of their call. We normally station them at Center Station. I can tell you, we can go through, if you want folks to hear what the response times are again. I have that when we did our, you know, our presentation to the town. That's your call. I have, you know, it's substantially different. And when you're basing it on an FPA standard, we're not meeting that. So we're talking, and this is just real rough numbers because it takes people time to get out of bed or get out of their, you know, get off their tractor and get to their car. But basically, in order, it takes 8 minutes and 39 seconds for somebody to get in their personal vehicle to respond from the town line to Center Station. So the total elapsed time for our engine to get on scene to a structure fire in the Shattuck Road area is 20 minutes and 36 seconds. That an FPA standard for a call force is 14 minutes. Mm-hmm. So, and then again, John, you can attest to this, what nowadays in this type of construction, we're also basing it off of NFPA, which is not up to date on the fire loads, what's inside the homes, the mm-hmm. construction types now. So if you're looking at a 20 minute response time, how much of the house is gonna be left? Very little.
And another big question and another concern that I've been approached with is mutual aid. And mutual aid is a big thing, but the town of Sunderland is a volunteer call force also.
Right.
I had just spoken to Jerry about it, and they have particular people on call every day, 7 days a week. But they're also running the ambulance, too.
No longer.
No longer
running the ambulance.
No. They've got that.
The ambulance has been moved regionally.
Okay, so it's out of their station completely. It's not there for backup.
Yep.
It was still.
There's a backup there, I think it's on the.
It was still there.
It's a backup, but it's not me.
Correct, it's south, south.
But those.
South Deerfield.
South Deerfield.
South County.
It's still a secondary, and their response time is similar to ours. So even if you had called the town of Amherston to get to Shattuck Road, you still are looking at more than that 14 minutes roughly.
Correct.
Yeah, they have to go down Pine Street.
Well, the other issue is.
Oh, yeah. Those DPW guys over there.
Mutual aid, I just want everybody to understand that too, because I've been hearing that coming up. We have mutual aid, let them handle these calls. Mutual aid is designed when all of our resources are tapped. That's the design of mutual aid. It's not to, okay, you're coming to all of our fires, certainly we have that set up, that happens.
Yeah.
But it's not designed for people to have to leave their communities and give up their responsibilities for their own calls in order to cover our community. Our community needs to take care of its own fire hazards.
So then back to Dave Wiskiewicz's point, so that there is an advocation for a North Hadley station by the Municipal Building Committee and certainly our public safety folks, and then the select board's going to vote whatever way we vote when the article comes up. But the parcel that we're talking about in this article, then the question becomes, even if you don't buy into the fact that we have a need for a North Hadley fire station, is it a prudent thing for the town to do? And I think we also need to have that framed out for the article as well. Because some people may say, Mike's got too much equipment, we don't need to do that, but yeah, it would be good to have another parcel of land. I just think we need to cover all bases on this.
Thanks. Say one other thing. And the building committee can chime in if you could help out with this one. But our initial setup of the structure on that, when we were talking about actual structural sites, Mm-hmm. So, we actually, our first go at it was kind of the, what would you need? The 100-year look at this. With the ability to expand on it. We kind of went the expanded way of it, so I think we could certainly review that. And, the building that was originally spec'd out for cost, I don't think is actually the building that we would actually have to present to the town. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. We don't need a 6-bay fire station
right up
on that property or whatever property it was assigned to be on.
I think we're working back to the property itself. And the property itself, if the CPA is going to fund a portion of it and we're going to use it.
We don't know that.
I'm putting it out
make
there.
Make the assumption.
I hope one of them are running down right now to talk to us about it. But we're making the assumption, and if it's going to be part of Park and Rec, I think it's a win-win for the town. That the property that we have there right now that we're going to sell is nowhere near big enough to do what Park and Rec are doing there now and the fire department's doing there now.
But you could just put a fire station there. You could knock the old Hadley Town building up there down, and it would be a sufficient piece of property to put up a really good building.
We reviewed that. There's some faults to that. The turning radius of the road, the proximity to the road, because we have to still back in the trucks, the idea that it's so close to the water creates another issue. So the question is, can we build there? Of course we can. But is it better to relocate it for other reasons? Yes. And that's why we have looked at other properties, because there are faults with that.
Well, I'm not saying we don't need more property. I'm not saying that at all. But what I'm saying is,
but those are the reasons why.
Yeah, exactly.
Those are the reasons why we can give. What was the reason of selling it and not building?
Yeah.
The reason is there are maybe multiple reasons why.
So you still wouldn't have enough knocking that down and using.
We don't have enough
parcels.
We don't have enough area frontage to be able to bring the trucks in and not back them in from the road. It's got a bad corner, not visually correct for for that type of use. So there are multiple reasons why that was looked at and dropped.
Right. So let's kind of wrap up a little bit here. So we have multiple people saying we do need to buy a piece of property for recreation uses and a station. And we have a piece of property, someone responded to us. We have some disagreement on what the price may be in the future, but when we have a good estimate coming, and we still have to go out for the RFP if we actually move forward with this. So the article, part of the article right now, you're trying to get funded by CPA as recreation.
Right.
And then if that happens, then it'd just be a piece of money coming from town, the town piece.
There's a couple of hurdles for the CPA that are on a relatively tight time frame to turn around, but I believe that's underway, right?
We have been covered. We've been working that. We have everything covered. We got a special meeting Monday night. They will definitely approve it, give us some money. The amount depends on our new appraisal, and we talked to an appraiser who today, I met with him today. He will have the appraisal by Monday, which is unheard of. And then we've got a special meeting with the CPA Monday night. They're setting up a special meeting just to go over this. And then they're going to put it on an article for the town meeting. That's if, right now, the selectmen want me to continue moving this or you want me to drop it.
For us to say drop it or move it is not something I think we can do right now. We've been pushing this for a while and we've been moving this for a while. There are wickets that have to be met. And if the person who answered the RFI sees what's going on and is still willing to sell the property as wickets are being met, and then we go and do our process of putting an RFP out to purchases, then that's great. That's really all I can say.
I absolutely want you to continue, because the taxpayers are entitled to know all these answers.
Yep.
How they vote is how they vote, but yes, at least you
exactly
have all the information available to
that's
them.
That's what I'm getting.
I said right away,
don't stop.
Absolutely no reason not to leave this article on and put it in front of
people. I'm doing something I'm not supposed to.
When did that ever bother you?
You're getting very good estimates for us, so we know what we need to do.
The other piece that some may ask for and you don't have yet is the development cost to make that a usable recreational area.
What do you mean? We have an expert sitting right at your left-hand side as to what it takes to make U9 fields available in town of Hadley.
There's a little bit of grading required before that happens. It'd be a very steep hill that you're playing soccer on or something.
Yeah, it's a lot of extra grading.
We don't have those numbers, and you know, we're a little cautious to keep going after stuff if it's not in the interest of your board for us to pursue it.
We mounted a community-based campaign the last time when we had the previous field development committee that did the work out behind the elementary school. We were fortunate to get the support of the town to gain access to the George Edwards money. And with some seed money, there usually you can go out and get matching donations out there quite often. And hopefully if this were to go through, whether it's this parcel or any parcel, if we see development of it for Park and Rec, then we hope to have another community-based effort to make improvements on it. Not going to say it's without any cost, but you know, hopefully we can defray a lot of that through community donations and labor.
But I thought you were planning on the sale of the Turka Park to offset some of the development of a building for you and in the fields. Whatever.
I don't want to jump too far down that road yet, but that article, originally when that the Zaterka Park article came up, this parcel was not in play.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And this has grown out, and if it works together, it would be somewhat serendipitous. But, you know, the intention for the Zaterka Park article was that we have this parcel that it's not maintained because it's not really being used for much. It's not being used for much because it's too small to do much with, and it has too much slope. So that's the case, let's turn it into funds that we could then buy a parcel that the town could use. In a nutshell, let's jump into, ahead to other articles.
Okay, so we're kind of sitting here and we've gotten a lot of good information, but we need some more numbers, and you guys are working on that for next week. That's our next meeting, right?
CPA can only match what the assessed value is, whatever the.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of cool things from CPA.
Relative to this property, what can we get for you to help you make a decision? The development cost for the recreational areas?
I think we'll need that for town meeting possibly, but the other thing we need to do is just find out where all the money, if CPA says no, I think we might be done for this town meeting. We have to wait until annual town meeting to bring it up again. So that's kind of how I see it, but the only thing I think we really need to know is how CPA is going to play into this.
So where does the RFP fit in all of this timeline?
Which RFP?
Well, you're saying we need an RFP to be able to purchase the land at some point, but we don't, isn't that part of getting a figure on what the land is going to be worth and what they're willing to sell the town?
I think where we are now is that we would do an RFP after a fall town meeting if it's so voted.
Upon the support of the town.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's going to be pretty hard to put a number in there, no matter how you look at it.
Well, you got to put an estimate in there, and whether we spend that whole amount or less, that's where it goes.
Well, we'll get it Monday night from CPA. We know and then, how much he wants to sell it, and that's the difference.
And then the one thing we have to also think about is, do we borrow on the levy, or do we borrow as a tax exclusion?
Exclusion, yeah.
That's the other thing we have to do.
I think having a number to fit in here will really help answer that question, because we know how much is coming off debt service within the levy and how much is coming off as debt exclusion between 16 and 17.
So that's what I guess kind of what we need. If CPA says yes, we like the Park and Rec proposal, this is how much we're authorizing into there, then we have to sit down and decide if we want to do the other share and where we're going to get it from.
But even if CPA says no, it still has to come back.
Yeah, it does.
Right. So, I mean, I wouldn't make that blanket statement.
Oh, well, no, that's kind of CPA says. Yeah, CPA says what they're going to do. And
yeah.
So you want to see us next Wednesday?
We'll
get the CPA stuff. We'll get all them.
You also have some other numbers from the other ones,
Tuesday,
yes.
Get together with you meeting Wednesday?
Yes, or you can just give it to us. Unless you really want to talk about it. The goal was to talk about it tonight and get it all hashed out, and then just get the numbers for. Willie, we like when you come visit us. Okay. So the last two?
Okay, looking at Article 22, this came out of discussions for modifications to a property marked Hadley to allow temporary storage of public safety vehicles, fire apparatus, and the like. Tim, do you want to talk to this?
Yes, I don't know how many of you are aware. We do have a possibility of rental space up in North Hadley for the fire station, and we haven't been able to do anything because the person hasn't purchased the property until today. So we will, Mike and I, a few of us, will go out and look at the property, figure out what section of the building that we can rent. We're going to be sitting down with you guys for sure, coming up with some type of a five-year rental agreement with them. And with that'll
estimate.
Give us a stopgap for the fire station for the time being.
Five-year estimate of what it would be?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So the
money's that article is going to have to be for rentals, for possibly doing some minor work within the building to secure our properties and whatever might be needed. I don't. And the hope is we can get you that before town meeting, but we're going to have to do that next week.
So on this article, just looking at Amherst, at the, how the North Hadley Hall is going, we have some more time. I think we have a little more time in this. We got the preservation, draft preservation restrictions. We're going to look that over, look over the RFP next meeting as well. So we won't get probably any responses back from the RFP until end of November, first of December at the earliest. For if we do North Hadley Hall, mm-hmm. and then we have to decide which way we're going to go. So we're going to be in the middle. Well, we're going to be in the February, March time frame, which will be just around the corner from town meeting. Mm-hmm. So I understand we might need to put some money aside, or might have some money for this. But we may be able to wait until. I mean, we can draft the RFP such that we have time in the building, because if we find a user, we can draft some time to have time in the building to get us to a point like January 1st or some other point after town meeting, annual town meeting, and then start something.
I understand. My hope is that when we actually do sit down with him, that he's going to come up with some nice figures for us that we're going to be very happy with.
So you get a very good estimate?
Yes. So I'm going to come back with a very good estimate that you're going to like and say, hey, it's really not that much money. It might be wise to go forward with it. And just in case something does happen, like last year with North Hadley, that we could actually put those vehicles in a better place in the middle of winter. That's what my hope is.
When's the new fire truck coming? Like, what's the estimate on that?
10 months plus.
10 months?
Maybe August or
next year.
Next year.
Hopefully.
Right, and that's going to go in
center station.
Yeah.
And then engine 3 would need to go to north.
Goes up there.
And engine 3 is a little bigger than what's
correct.
There.
Right, and that's right. Where we need more space.
Right.
It'll also
10 months.
The space will give us some space.
That's a lower estimate. That's if everything's going good.
You know, what happened to just-on-time delivery, you know? Right. I remember that in the 80s and 90s.
Yeah,
you know, just in time. You wanted something, but you can get some from Amazon. Sorry, people. you can call up Amazon, their drones deliver it to you, but you just can't get a fire truck or a pump.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Oh, man. All right, sorry, that was my little thing for tonight. Yeah, off track. Back on track. So I think we're okay with that. So the question then would be, do we really need to put money now, or can we wait until annual town meeting?
It could very well be that we'll wait, but we just have it there because, again,
okay.
We might come up with some nice figures that you'll be very pleasantly surprised with.
And the agreement could also be worded in such a way that the monetary arrangement only kicks in at the point of use.
Yeah.
Yes.
So we're not really.
But then again, we still have to go out for a request for proposal to enter into our lease. That's one of the great things about the state. So even though we get this good estimate, we still have to go through a
even
procurement
it was
process.
Free?
We have to go through a procurement process of some type.
Okay.
We have to go through a procurement process.
Yeah, understood. We can get that going.
So, all right, so 23?
23, that is, I believe, the
supplemental funding.
That is the replenishment of the funding for the $50,000 for the consultant. And
but we only spent $1,000.
Right. And
with a possible $77.50 more.
When this first came up, there was a fair amount that was originally coming out of the town, and there's going to be $7,700 more. And if we decide to go ahead with some of these other projects, $50,000 isn't going to last too long, so we were looking at topping that fund back off for whatever we would have expended today.
Okay. So
you're looking to reallocate it to $50,000 again?
Yes. In the spring or now?
Honestly, I don't think that we could spend all that money and need more by the time spring comes around. I'd be hard pressed to say that that would be necessary this time, unless any of my committee disagrees.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, I mean, you've got three.
You got lots of volunteers all of a sudden.
There are a number of projects that other departments have been asking us to entertain. For instance, the library is looking at a ceiling project, which our consultant could assist with. So, you know, there's a few things. Now that we have a consultant, there's people that could use that.
Well, Russell School is going to be involved too, so.
The Russell School.
That's what I'm saying. You got the other two phases of Russell School. If in fact phase, yeah, but.
So you're going to pass over this one then?
Well, we've got 7750 out of the first phase funded. What happens? Will we wait till, I mean, we'll have some money in the account to spend?
Yeah, we're going to fund all three phases in this article.
Yeah.
So I see Russell School is all covered by the first article.
So 42 is enough.
So 24? You want to wait until annual town meeting for 24? So you want to take that off for now?
Let's talk about that Tuesday night. We'll come back on Wednesday. We'll
okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All righty.
Thanks, guys.
Anything else you want to say?
No, I just I'd like to thank the library trustees for the presentation on Monday night, which was an excellent presentation and gave us some good solid ideas on how we could proceed with the library expansion and how that might play into the Hooker School fate, if you will.
It's a good word.
So I think that this conversation will continue through our own meetings and through subsequent meetings with the library planning committee. But it was lively. There was a lot of interest, and I hope that it actually means that there'll be some more people at our meetings to discuss these important issues.
Okay. Well, again, I want to thank you, gentlemen. You do a great job. And this would not be moving forward at all if you weren't helping out with this. So thank you very much.
And the input last night was great as well.
And we'll see you. Well, we might see some of you next meeting, or you'll just give us the information. Either one, however you want to do it.
We'll communicate with the board before that.
You get some more medicine and you can come back.
Yeah, I was just going to say, thank the whole board for all your professional opinions and you, Willie.
Oh, no, 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 no.
Good luck Monday night.
Good job, guys. Thank you.
So,
thank you.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you, guys.
Hi, guys, Dave. Well, apparently, I'm getting a lot of support tonight. You need any backup?
Yeah, sure.
Do we want to talk some about park and rec articles?
Yeah, sure.
There are the four articles. There's the revolving fund article. And I support this.
What number are we on?
12?
12 is the first one?
Yeah, Article 12. Where are we? Article 12. So right now, Park and Rec has a revolving fund, which is set up by Mass General Law, Chapter 44, Section 53D. And this, by statute, carries a $10,000 cap as of July 1st, since the Park and Rec Department has a number of programs during the summer. Having that cap really impinges upon the full range of services that they could potentially provide. We went to the Department of Revenue and asked if we could amend this somehow, and they said that we could set up a regular revolving fund under Section 153 E and a half, and you know you're in Massachusetts when you have E and a half. And you're looking for a surplus cap of $20,000. And so long as we pass this before we set the tax rate, the Department of Revenue will allow us to do it. So this is revenue neutral for us.
Make a motion to support.
The actual law says 50,000, and we're
no, spending limit is something that we've set up. There is an overall spending limit, which I think is 1% of your EQB, and we're a long way away from that. Sorry. From the cumulative revolving funds that we have. We dropped Russell School, if you remember, that had a $100,000 spending limit, so we would have room to spare.
I'll second the motion on the floor for discussion.
Discuss away.
Well, not mine, I don't know if anybody else wants to. I'm fine.
Any other discussion on that? So we're going to start making, these are our recommendations for the articles.
If you have any questions about the genesis, I'll be happy to answer.
None.
No. All those in favor?
Aye.
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 So, I just placed something. So you're, oh, there it is, I got it. Oh, that's awesome, thank you. All right.
Third of 13.
13.
Okay, so this article has been bandied about before, which is the potential sale of Zaterka Park, which we had surveyed a few years back, and we even, based on some speculation that there was some contaminated material dumped there, we actually had that run through the, and pardon me while I forget the chapter, but David, you might have me there. We
sure.
had the
21E.
Yes, the
environmental.
The environmental yep. stuff. We had a full level one, thank you,
sure.
chapter 21E review of the site, and that came back with no need to proceed to level
Crazy.
Two. So.
Oh no!
Yay! The parcels involved are it's a 2 acre parcel.
Uh-oh.
2 acre parcel down at the Breckenridge in Huntington, and it goes up. There's a 4 acre parcel that runs back
yeah.
into the woods up at the top of the hill near the pit road. The thought was to since the park used to be maintained by Hadley Youth Baseball back in when that was in existence, when that ball field was being used. That field was ultimately idled, not only because of the annual sinkholes that would blossom, but the fact that the cars would pull up right behind the benches and there was absolutely no really safe parking and way to maintain the kids. We had a number of forums and discussions, the Park and Rec Commission that is, had a number of forum discussions where we're trying to figure out alternative uses for the park. We had a number of suggestions, some of which we consider to have limited appeal, such as a skateboard park, or it might present more difficulty to the police, but not necessarily bring benefit to the community. So ultimately, we've come to the point where it doesn't suit itself
purpose.
Well to a lot. I'm sorry?
It doesn't have a useful purpose at this point.
It doesn't have a useful purpose. We'd rather
to the town.
To the town. We'd rather sell it, take the proceeds, and buy a parcel that does have a usefulness for a community park elsewhere in town.
So before anybody makes a motion, let's talk about the next article.
Why?
Because they kind of go together, and as we talk them through, we might be able to combine the two into one article instead of having two separate articles.
Can I ask a question just about that one article, the one
sure.
we're talking about? So that's land that the town owns. We're talking about buying a parcel in North Hadley.
For a fire station?
Yep.
That was explored because of the topography and the depth of the site there. It was it's pretty steep up in the back, and it gets narrow. It's kind of a wedge shape for
mm-hmm.
a level spot back there. That came up last year when we were talking about potential sites and for a number of reasons, all of which I can't recall at this moment, it was not considered to be a good site for the fire station.
I think of because of the four-way
and it's not
area,
very wide.
Huntington,
it's not
Breckenridge.
Deep.
Yeah. It's kind of off a side road.
It's kind of a side road. It's not really.
Question will come up, so I'm just
yeah.
posing.
I'll make a motion to.
Wait a minute.
Oh, wait. Guilford wants to talk.
Chairman wanted to tie it together.
So the second, the next article?
The next article is the creation of a trust fund for the proceeds that would come from the sale of Zaterka Park. It was discussed in earlier years that we should do what we can to protect the money from falling directly into the general fund and being used to buy new floors. If we're going to sell it as the purpose of buying another parcel for a park in town, we want to ensure that those funds are available. There was some discussion about the George Edwards Fund being used as that vehicle, and through my inquiries, I was told that that wasn't an acceptable vehicle. So
why isn't it acceptable?
Because the municipality can't set up a trust fund or add money to a trust fund directly, but we can set up a stabilization fund, special purpose stabilization for this purpose. As a technical matter, we can't create a fund without a balance in it, and the sale of the property would result in a balance going there probably by a town meeting vote in the future. So we would have to create a stabilization account for Park and Rec and put a dollar of...
So there was...
There you go.
It's totally logical to me that you can't add to a fund.
No, it's, so it's similar to the way you set up Russell School originally.
Yeah.
And it's specific for whatever we decide it's going to be.
So the George, what fund?
Edwards.
Edwards Fund is set up for recreation. It's not a trust fund, it's a fund.
No, it is a trust fund.
This is a donation from a private individual upon their passing, so the exact, and this is the comments from the executor in the will. So exactly how the fund is set up outside of my area.
If it's just a donation fund, and it was put in the donation fund, that's the same as setting up another fund. The question is, do we need to keep making all these pots of money?
Right.
Park and Rec does have a donation fund as well, but you know, I don't know, again, I'm just trying to safeguard the funds for future use for a parcel.
When it was intended for Park and Rec and
Rec. Which is an appropriate vehicle to do that.
So the question is, do we want to make a fund or do we want to incorporate it into another fund?
If we can legally do that. I don't know that we can legally add to the George Edwards Fund.
Well, maybe we can't George Edwards Fund, maybe add to the Park and Rec Fund.
Who has purview, but this comes into ownership and control, and then who has purview to expend funds out of a fund?
Town,
so we don't want,
two-thirds. Yeah,
we don't want
this. It has to be appropriated by the town.
Yeah, I mean, we're saying we wouldn't want to put it somewhere where then, not that you would go spending willy-nilly, but, you know, where the commissioners could go off and...
Water park?
Build a water park, yeah.
So a couple of things here is that... this money automatically would go into a special revenue account, but it would be available for any lawful purpose, so that becomes a target.
Mm-hmm.
By putting it in a special stabilization account, you protect its use to what that was originally set up to do, which would, in this case would be for Park and Rec. You wouldn't be spending it on schools or buses or something like that. The other thing that's happening here is in Article 13, we're talking about selling property and then using money from that sale to create a fund, and town meetings don't have that ability to dictate to future town meetings what can happen. So by creating the fund now, we establish it, and then later on, when we sell the property, we can transfer that money in for that purpose.
Seems like the way to go.
I'm okay with however you guys vote on it. I personally don't see making another fund. And we've been making all these little funds, but if that's we have to go.
Well, let's hope this is not a little fund. And consider it a
sizable. All right, so we're going to keep them apart. I'll make a motion.
Motion second on the floor, didn't we?
For discussion?
Are you talking about 13 and then
yes.
We can do
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I would like to just name it the Joe Zaterka Recreational Fund.
Well, we can't do that, is what we're being told now. So we're just gonna.
No, what he said was we can't add to the George Edwards.
Well, it's just a Park and Rec Stabilization Fund.
Yeah, we're just gonna make a new fund.
John's trying to add the respect to the gentleman who
to the original donor.
No, he wasn't. He wasn't the donor. It was named after him in his name. It's not. He was not
he
the donor of the property.
Okay. All right. So we have Article.
Is that what that is? You got
13. We have voting.
Motion on
the
floor.
Motion and second on the floor.
All those in favor.
Aye.
To sell the property. Now to set up another fund to put the money into Article 14. Is there a motion?
So moved.
Second.
So last discussion item, we should really have some type of good explanation at town meeting why we have to make another fund.
Mm-hmm.
All right, any other discussion?
You gonna get up to the microphone and ask?
I'm not.
would ask you guys to help out on this.
But I really think, I mean, I don't see a problem with any one of these personally, so. All right, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Capital Planning voted last, Monday night on Article.
Wait, we got one more.
Okay.
14, 15, sorry. Article 15 for the survey money.
Yes. Obviously, to sell the property, while we have had it surveyed, we would need a, surveyed during the previous chapter 20B.
Yeah, we have deeds for these two parcels, so.
Through that effort.
Mm-hmm.
I think we, but I'm gonna, in any event, there's certainly some upfront expenses for an appraisal if we're gonna consider selling it to a private entity, as well as the potential for a survey. And while we wouldn't have the funds to refund, to fund it upfront, we would look to reimburse the town for the expenditures, but in the short term, get money for the survey and an appraisal.
Well, actually, you do have the funds.
We do. I don't think it's a two-thirds town majority vote to use this, and it has to be for recreational purposes.
Yeah, I don't think that.
It is to get rid of a recreation purpose, buy another recreation purpose.
Well, but there's no foregone conclusion that we have, that would happen.
Survey.
There's no foregone conclusion in any of these at town meeting.
You can't use that for that.
Mm.
I feel a little funny using that.
Yeah.
That money for.
So how much money do we need?
Have you spoke to any real estate agents regarding this yet?
Not formally. There are the potential of four building lots there, at least sort of from a frontage standpoint. Whether or not, you know, somebody's gonna have to put a lot of fill in on the middle ones. So there may obviously some suppressed value there.
So how much are you asking for?
I think six would be a 6,000 would be a high number, but it would certainly give us some headroom for a survey and or appraisal, and then
that
it's probably
like
more like 3,500.
I would think it'd be closer to 3,000 then.
We're going to be back next Wednesday. Would you have a chance to talk to a real estate agent in between now and next Wednesday?
Actually,
so that we could.
Yeah, just get a survey estimate.
Because we, if we have the deeds.
I'll get you a stronger number for next Wednesday.
Which will need to be split anyways.
All right.
Capital Planning. Voted support Article 13. The only caveat on it was to make sure that there was no pending restrictions when the property was donated to the town of Hadley.
Oh, for Sir Jacob Park? Sorry.
And you got that original deed?
All right. So make sure there's no restrictions on selling it?
Yeah, when this article first came up a couple of years ago, we went all the way through that process. And I believe you have a lot of that information from the last time.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay. So we kind of worked all through that. Do you want to talk some articles? Move some articles out of the way, or we want to wait till we have a longer meeting, next meeting?
Do you want to do the capital expenses, since capital's already made a recommendation?
Well, we can do all the money ones if we want to and talk about the fact that we are spending a lot of money and if we want to spend a lot of money.
Check the article one.
Well, we can start with one and work through all the money ones.
Article 1, you got to do.
So, Article 1, yes, we have to do.
I'm leaving.
Okay, that's fine.
I sat through this with you the other day.
Good luck. Let us know what you need.
Mm-hmm.
Have any announcements you want me before you leave?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, so we're going to go through the articles. We'll start with number one. So before we start, the thing we should realize is what we think is free cash that we have, or will have, or will be certified is...
$789,000 and change.
Okay. So Article 1, we have to do this. This is just closing out last year, and it's roughly $39,206 we have to spend out of that. $789. Okay. Is there any other discussion?
No.
I'll make a motion to approve Article 1.
Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Is that unanimous?
I'm going to abstain on it right now. I still have a problem with no finance committee and no other public input here.
This is a select board.
I understand.
Okay.
John, what is your vote for the record?
Abstain.
Okay,
so now we're into Article 2, which are adjustments for this year's budget, which we haven't really decided what to do with some of the COLAs and salaries. So this would be where we would put those in. We do have, do you want to run through and tell us what we know we have to spend?
Okay, so start with town accountant because Gail is leaving for another job elsewhere and we wish her the very best at that. We need to, we're working with two outfits to set up a regional or shared accounting service. So that would be a vendor cost. So we would have to combine the salaries and expenses for town accountant into one line so that we could have enough money to cover both the audit and the accounting services. And I'll have a firmer figure for you at next week's meeting. But that would be a combination of two accounts into one. There's no increase right now, but that's something we have to do.
Well, it actually can't be the total amount of both accounts because we spent some salary.
This would be to authorize the total for the year, not the balance for year to date.
Oh, so you wouldn't leave the amount expended in salary and then just move the rest of it?
Yeah, you have to leave. I mean, we're moving unexpended salary into the operating,
right,
so to cover a contract.
But you've got to show Department of Revenue that you're raising the stuff that you've already expended as well. So it's the,
yes,
total.
So you have zero increase. You have $69,000 for accountant salaries here.
Yep.
And then you're not decreasing that, and you're not increasing that.
Correct.
And then you have $26,000, which is the expense account line for accountant. And then you're increasing that to $95,000.
The 69 should be decreased.
That's the 69.
69 goes down to zero. And we're combining 69 and 26 to make 95.
Okay, so then my question is, we've already spent part of that 69,000,
right,
so you can't have, you can't decrease it by 69,000.
Yeah, I think we have to leave the true salary portion in there.
I see what you're saying. I'll double check that, but I don't think that's what the way the Department of Revenue would look at it.
But don't we also have to say we're decreasing that line?
Yeah, he has the 69 going to zero, and then everything going.
Yeah, so we're taking the total year salary and expenses. And we're combining them into one salary and expense so that we have the flexibility to spend.
I understand
the whole thing.
But the way
we have to show the Department of Revenue that we have the whole year, even though we're halfway through it, is funded.
I understand.
Okay.
But what my question is, my concern here is you have increases and decreases shown in this one column.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're showing all the increases, but you're not showing any decreases, that's not...
I see what you mean, right. I understand. And so the increases and decreases here are notes that would not appear in the final form of the article. It would be just the from to, not showing a plus or a minus. That's just for our use right now. The posted version of the warrant would not have those notes within the prints.
Okay. So what else?
Okay, so insurance, 193, we set it at 113,000. It turned out to be 103,400, so that's a decrease of 9,600. So we can transfer that money in effect over to workers' comp, which we set at 50,000, but it turned out to be 65,594. So
it was partially funded.
Partially funded. So we're offsetting it by that maneuver there.
Okay.
All right. Town hall expenses. I'm increasing that by 4,000 to get our board docs program up and running. If you remember, we had asked the finance committee for a $4,000 reserve fund transfer. Without finance committee, we can't legally do that. So this is the other way of doing that. If we have a finance committee reconstituted, we can drop that increase and do it as a reserve fund transfer.
But at this point, it's moot because the finance committee reserves just went back. Didn't it just get turned back as part of free cash anyway?
Last year's. This year's, right. We have 50,000. So we're
right.
Good. And we asked for the transfer this fiscal year, not last fiscal year.
Oh, okay. I thought it was the end of last year.
Nope.
Okay.
Let's see, communication. There is in the police salaries, we would have to increase the chief's salary in order to meet our contractual obligation of about $5,000 in there. We had budgeted 90,000. We signed a contract for 95, so there's going to be a $5,000 increase there at a minimum. $440 debt and interest for the wastewater. We shortchanged that by $1,582, and that was just an oversight on multiple people's part as we're putting that together. Long-term debt and interest, increasing that by $8,090 for the principal and $2,100 for the interest. And again, that was a calculation that didn't make it fully into the annual town meeting. These two amounts, the $8,090 and the $2,100, are both debt excluded, so there's no net impact on our overall financial picture for that. Mm-hmm. Workers' comp, $50,000 to $65,594. I spoke about that before. And OPEB from zero to $245,000 if we can manage that. If we can make the $245,000, then we are at or very, very close to the stop the bleeding mark for OPEB. We will have achieved an important milestone. So
what was the increase last year in OPEB?
OPEB, we went down slightly from one actuarial report to the other, so there was a decrease in both the overall liability, size of liability, and there was a decrease in our required contribution.
What was the amount of last year's OPEB?
Somewhere in the neighborhood of $7 million.
I think he's talking, are you talking about the funding?
The funding.
Oh, the funding, $164,888.
So what's the total we're adding?
$80,000.
No, what's the total in this article we're adding right now?
That depends on what we intend to do for wage increases, if we're gonna do it.
Right, so what are we, what's the,
looks like to be 200 and almost 300,000.
262,770?
Yeah.
Okay, so then wages is the other thing we have to think about adding for this one. Do we add COLAs and steps for the non-union at this time? We haven't got one of our unions to settle yet. As we go through negotiations, we're still negotiating. so.
Just for information purposes, if you give everybody a COLA, everybody gets something. And if you give everybody a step, then not everybody gets a step.
We've had this discussion a few times, about the step process and the wage study, and how many times are we going to go through this without any facts?
Well, the fact is we have to either decide not to give steps and COLAs now, or give step and COLAs now. We are negotiating, and when we resolve our negotiations, more than likely, each of the bargaining units is going to get a retro COLA and step. So do we want to treat the non-union the same way and go ahead and put that in the budget now so they can start getting their step and COLA? Or do we want to wait and do it at the same time we do all the unions?
Well, we could also do a hybrid approach, meaning maybe give something as a, I'm going to use the word token, but as a token now. And then when the contracts settle, readdress it.
Strictly as a financial management plan, that's a much better idea. Before we spend all the rest of the money that we have in our free cash.
And that's always been balanced at the beginning of the annual town meeting anyway, through negotiations throughout the years, so.
So if we give a step, if we give this COLAs right now, and we base the COLA on whatever we're negotiating with, that's how much money?
So if you give the COLA, based upon the figures that we had before, it would be $15,121 for the general fund, and for the enterprise funds, $1,800. 93 for HPAT would be 502 for a combined cost of $17,515. That's a 1.5% COLA.
That's 1.5.
1.5. If you give a step with no COLA, it's $20,016 for the general fund, $441 for the enterprise funds, and $1,204 for the cable funds, for a total $21,660.
We can also give a 1% COLA. I mean, we don't.
Well, if we're going to do something, what you're saying, I would say go ahead and give the step. That's a known number.
The step is where you're getting into trouble all the time with the financial side of it. The COLA is something that you're working into the budgets. And this is what it looks like they have ran into in the past.
Well,
and the steps really don't justify any of the positions, the qualifications. And I spoke about that too.
I understand. And until we resolve how we're going to change the pay structure, we've always given steps until you get to our top steps.
Do we know how many people would not get an increase if we did steps only? Not get an increase now.
Not counting the accountant.
Truly, it's a $3,000 difference.
Well, some people don't get it.
I know, but truly, if we were to allocate the money today, it's $3,000.
Looks like 9 people would not get a step who are non-union.
So my preference would be to do both. So it would be a $35,137 increase.
And then we're locking that into future budgets. I mean, that's...
Yep.
Yep, so this is a roll forward.
It is.
Yep.
Same with negotiations. It's a roll forward.
Right.
I agree with that.
Yeah, but we want to be clear at town meeting. Sometimes that gets lost.
but it is what we've done in the past. And until we come up with another solution on how to handle this, which we won't be able to do between now and town, annual town meeting, it's treating everybody the same way they've been treated.
Yeah, so I guess my only question is just doing the full amount. So
we have a motion to do the
35 and change.
Is there a second?
I'll second it.
Any more discussion? All those.
So I assume that your vote is tentative, that we'll put together the overall budget based upon your decision, and we'll see where we are at your next meeting and see how that.
No, I think this is how we're saying we're going to add this to the.
Right.
You came up with 39.
No. We do have to. This is only to vote to add this number to it.
Yep.
This isn't the actually to support this article, because we do have to get the rest of the final numbers for this article. Mm-hmm. So this is only to add that number to this.
Okay.
You want to hold this till next week?
We can if you want.
I think we should. Let's just make sure we have the right.
I'd like to rescind my motion.
Yours.
I'll rescind my second.
Okay, so those are the numbers. So actually.
Are you sure the number's not 43,175?
No.
49.
David,
no, I'm asking.
David, your COLA is 17,515, is that correct?
Right, that's
and your step is 21,660?
Right, but that includes
okay.
both HPAT
yes.
and enterprise
yes.
funds.
So that's 49,175 a total. Unless I added it.
Yeah, you also, I was just talking to general fund.
Okay.
It was going to come from free cash.
Okay.
Sorry. Yeah. Sorry. So there's one other item to talk about in the budget for 2016, and that is we took HPAT money from what we get from Comcast, and we used that to balance the budget, and we said we'd look at replacing some of that money with general fund money, or replacing all that money with general fund money. So we need to know, we need to decide whether we're going to do that, because that would be the time to do that.
They've changed the law. So that's Article 3 coming up. Under the cable franchise agreement, Comcast would give Charter would give us money. We would spend that as we decided. Department of Revenue said you can't do that anymore, and so now you have to appropriate money at annual town meeting or at a town meeting for not this year but next year's expenditures. So we're going to be in a position where we're going to have to be doing that anyways. So if you use general fund monies for HPAT this year, this would be the last year that you would be doing that.
And what's the balance in there right now?
100 and what?
It's more than that. I want to say it's $189,000 from the operating budget and something on the order of $75,000 for capital.
It's a little less than $75,000 right now.
Okay.
So that money is. So what can we use that money for?
For him.
That's all we can use it for?
Yep.
And his assistant, probably.
Yeah,
assistant.
Capital and
have you hired anybody
expenses.
Yet, Richard? What's going on over there? We're not getting all our meetings on tapes. You have no help. What's going on? Maybe we need to get the applications and hire somebody for you.
All right. So we can't make that adjustment in this year's budget, so we have to do.
Well, you have to do it for next year anyways. You can do what you'd like to do for this year's budget, but
next year we won't be able to take
right.
money from that to cover it.
Right.
So I'm quite frankly inclined
leave it alone.
To leave it alone now, and then next year we're going to have to fund it anyway.
Okay. Anything else?
Okay.
All right. So Article 3.
That's the law that we have to adopt the particular chapter and verse of the Mass General Laws. Right now, Department of Revenue has not come out with any kind of guidelines, informational guidelines on this. So taking this one step we have to do before June 30th, 2016, might as well get it out of the way now. But I wouldn't take any further steps towards making appropriations. Not until Department of Revenue comes out with guidelines.
Okay, so Is there a motion on this article?
I'll make a motion to approve.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Upstate.
All right, so Article 4 is gone. Article 5 is capital stabilization.
Motion approved.
Second.
All right, so discussion. So 789,000 is what we have. We spent roughly 300,000. We spent over 300,000, 350,000 doing the budget, balancing the budget. Mm-hmm. So we'll spend another 300,000 putting it into capital stabilization. Mm-hmm. We're 100% okay with that.
If you go to the recommendation of the capital committee, they're recommending.
Well, this number is representative of the meals tax, correct?
Correct.
Okay, so I mean that we're just following past practices regarding using the meals tax for capital stabilization.
We've talked about changing our practice.
Yeah.
But isn't this just a follow through on?
Follow through on
last year's budget process.
Mm-hmm. Right. It kind of is, but we still have to appropriate. We still have to recommend that what we buy with all this money.
Right. Okay. So, are you suggesting that we're not going to be?
The question is whether we want to go ahead and set 300,000 aside now, or whether we want to set some other number aside.
So, without the 300, what would be available for?
We do have to set something aside. If we go through with all the things that was approved by the capital,
right.
We do need some money. We need
that's
about right. 200.
223,620.
So are you
leaving approximately 77,000
yeah.
right.
left over.
So if we don't fully fund the 300, then that would remain in free cash.
Right.
And it would be far more flexible in free cash than it would be in a capital stabilization. Now I'm with you. Now I got you.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I wasn't following my math when you were rattling off the numbers. I thought that we needed more than the 300.
No.
Okay.
But then again, what we don't know, so this may be a thing we take up next week too,
mm-hmm.
is we don't know what the building committee is going to ask for.
Exactly.
But if we take a lot of what the building committee is asking for, we could take from
other
spots,
mm-hmm.
mostly Russell School.
Mm-hmm.
And then the question is, how much do we have to put in for the property if we put in for the property? So
that won't be known until next week anyway.
It won't be
yeah.
there. So that's the question. That's my question about the 300,000. Right now it's more than what we need.
Mm-hmm.
It could be less than what we need. So I kind of phrased that wrong. It's being late. I'm already burning out.
I'm fine holding until next week until we have it in the context of the Municipal Building Committee.
Okay. So next we have capital, what the capital committee voted for. Would you like to talk to that?
Just make sure everybody has the same information. So I sent around minutes for the Capital Planning Committee. Unfortunately, I didn't follow all the ins and outs, and so I had a higher number from Capital Planning that they're for their recommendation than they're actually willing to do. So they're talking about 995,620 in capital projects. That would include a school bus, two trucks, an international 7600, a backhoe, a pickup truck for the sewer department, a clarifier rehabilitation for the wastewater treatment plant, a light truck for water, telephone system for the police, rifles for the police, ballistic helmets and gear for the police, radar units for the police, a locker room improvement for the police.
No.
Air packs.
Yeah.
That was stricken.
Air packs for the fire. Let me just read through
mm-hmm.
this and
okay.
then we can circle around. Fire department gets the air packs and a split air conditioner system for the basement of the library. Borrowing would be 495,000. Capital stabilization 223,620. borrowing, taking from the sewer reserves of $20,000, transferring from the sewer impact fees of $207,000, and transferring from water reserves of $50,000 to make all of those appropriations. There were two projects that were listed that were not approved by capital. The first one was the $12,000 for repairs to the North Hadley Village Hall, and the other one was $29,900 for the exercise room at the public safety complex. Those were not recommended.
As well as the locker room improvement.
I didn't have that in my notes.
I would caution you to recheck those.
Okay.
Or it's my understanding that that's not. Okay.
So out of that, we need 223,620 for capital stabilization,
mm-hmm.
and then the rest will come. So there's multiple motions here?
Yes. So the motions are the first, there are four motions. The first motion would be the straight appropriations from capital stabilization, sewer impact fees, water and sewer reserves. And that takes care of the majority of those. But then there's the school bus for $140,000. Which would have to be borrowed. $200,000 for the International 7600 truck for DPW. $155,000 for the backhoe for the DPW.
Do we know the, Jerry, you're set through this too. You know the age of the DPW equipment that's being, is this replaced or in addition to?
I do not know the ages.
So,
and will those be debt exclusion or not?
The borrowing.
Yeah,
just
motion
borrowing.
2, 3, and 4 debt exclusions.
Yep,
right?
There'd be debt exclusions.
And we have a lot, we have debt coming off.
Yep.
Debt exclusions, so this is just replacing it, keeping things even.
Yeah, you have $100,000 coming off debt from 16 into 17. Debt service.
So do we want to take a position on this now?
No, you don't have to. Michael can provide. That's a, Molly's question is very poignant.
I think we should have information in front. I mean, I know capital planning approved it, and I'm typically inclined to defer to them, but I'd like to make sure I understand what we're doing here.
And how old it was?
Yeah, I don't know if it's new equipment, if it's
okay.
Replacement of existing or what.
Yeah, all the vehicles are replacement of scheduled replacement.
Scheduled replacements.
And the clarifier rehabilitation is a number one priority by our wastewater capital plan.
Mm-hmm.
And the impact fees are there to begin with.
Right.
Well, it's not coming out of impact fees, it's coming out of
the clarifier is.
Yeah, the clarifier is coming out of sewer impact.
No, sewer impact fees. That's
okay.
What it says here.
So are we going to hold until we have the...
We can. So the next article is the water line.
So this is for the Route 9 water line. And we were hoping they'd do this through the SRF program, but that is not going to happen prior to town meeting. So we're doing this as a straightforward borrowing within the Enterprise Water Fund. $628 for the borrowing for the Route 9 project.
Sir, we want to do this one?
I'll make a motion.
So moved.
Second.
All those in, any more discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Abstain.
Okay. Laura, Anna. Lane Sewer, we got to restore excess funds.
All right, so we didn't need as much money for Lorana Lane as we originally thought. This was an emergency appropriation, so we'd be returning about $26,000 in change to the sewer reserves.
So moved.
Second.
Any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Abstain.
Hopkins Academy insurance adjustment?
So moved.
Our authorization?
Second.
So just so everyone knows at home, this is the take insurance money and put it into an account so we can pay the bills for the damage that was done by the broken
steam pipe.
Yeah. Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Laurel Drive acceptance. Do we have our viewing times?
The viewing for Laurel?
Yeah, so we're hoping to do this on October 8th at 4 o'clock. We're going to try to do both of them, so I hope that meets your schedule.
I'm very familiar with both roads.
So did you ask if we have to all be present for the viewing or just us?
For the viewing, you only need one person, but for the formal vote, you need a quorum.
But you don't vote there. You do the viewing on site.
Might as well do it while you're there.
So you have to have a quorum.
Yeah.
It's easier to just do it during the meeting, anyway.
Okay.
So... do we
think we need some information from Mr. Klimaski regarding both those?
Yeah.
There's a couple instances.
So we're going to do the viewing after we have to post the warrant. And we have to post the warrant on the 8th, right?
Right.
We could theoretically have our recommendation pending.
We could.
Yeah.
I mean, actually, why don't we do that?
Yeah.
Okay. Same for Holly.
There's a couple of hoops we still have to jump through on both these roads, and it'll be close to see if we can do all the legal work.
Okay, so 12 we did. 13, we're waiting for some, I'll come back with some information. Oh wait, we voted on 13, didn't we? Is there a Turker Park?
You recommended that.
I forgot to write that down.
You recommended 14.
Mm-hmm. And 14, we approved that. 15, we're holding for a number. Okay, so 17, all the municipal building ones, we're going to hold those till next time.
And I'll rewrite those according to their new presentation.
All right, and then CPA, we don't know what those are.
We have one. Just came in today. CPA, the first one is the one that they've acted on is for $1,650 for a sidewalk for Goodwin Memorial Library.
So moved.
Second.
So this is support this article.
Mm-hmm.
Any other discussion?
Nope.
All those in favor?
Aye.
I'm going to abstain this time.
Why?
I'm just abstaining.
Okay. No explanation? At least they give you an explanation.
Okay. Article 29, planning board article number 1.
We don't traditionally...
Yeah.
Do we want to not take a position on those?
We don't traditionally take a position on planning boards, do we?
No.
It's up to us.
Not unless there's a monetary... point here to be discussed.
Well, it actually just seems very housekeeping-ish.
That's it.
If it was actually something else, I would. So if you want to say no position?
No position.
No position
no,
it is.
Yeah.
Okay, so we kind of run through the whole, all of our items for tonight, except for our executive session. Is there anything else we want to talk about for the special town meeting? Any announcements?
It's not really an announcement, but thank you. I just want to thank Mrs. Weinzig and the Weinzig family. The other day, I happened to notice that underneath our sign out front of the public safety complex, there's some very beautiful flowers that she just randomly came over and planted because she wanted it to look nice. So I think she should be recognized for that, as well as the rest of the family. It was very nice.
That's very nice. Thank you.
Maybe you can get her to plant the flowers on the...
on the roundabout.
The roundabout.
Go ahead.
Okay. And tonight, the select board would like to express our condolences. Had a few losses here in town. First to the Zahowski family, who recently lost their sister, Landy Stava. So our well wishes to the family during this time. Also to the family of Walter Stone. I believe that's Judy Barstow Stone, as well as the family of Theodore Mish. So again, our condolences during this difficult time.
Yeah, it's a very difficult time. It's maybe a rash of this. So any other announcements?
At this point in time, I'd like to go into executive session. Board members would like to make a motion to move into executive session. As per Mass General Law Chapter 30A, Section 21A2, to conduct a strategic session in preparation for negotiations for non-union personnel. Non-union personnel. Or to conduct collective bargaining sessions or contract negotiations with non-union personnel.
Roll call vote. Mr. Kevitz?
Yes.
Devine?
Yes.
Maureen?
Yes.
Keegan?
Yes.
Thank you.
So as chair of the Hadley Select Board, I state that the board has moved and seconded to enter into an executive session. I state that the discussion of the matter in open session would have an adverse effect on the town of Hadley. So thank you very much, and I'll see you next week.
One more thing. I'd just like to express, I think we'd be remiss if we didn't say that our hearts go out to our neighbors, the town of Amherst, for the loss of John Musandi over there. I know he meant an awful lot to that town. He was a wonderful person to deal with in every facet of working with him. And our thoughts and prayers are with the Musandi family and the town of Amherst at this time.
All right. Good night, everybody.